Hi there guys, welcome back to the channel. Mike the Muppet Modeler here, and before we get going I'd like to say a massive thank you to all my subscribers, new ones, existing ones, those of you that have just found the channel and those that have been with me from the start. You're all just as important and I love you all. Another bit of news, just gone past the 3000 hour watch time mark, so that is absolutely awesome, absolutely amazing, and just wow, it just blows me away, to be honest. But anyway, moving on. As you can see on the bench, we have the Tornado GR1 Gulf War Revell kit, 1/32nd scale. So I thought we would maybe crack on with some brush painting today. And I think we'll start off by painting the cushions, the seats, the seat and the seat back. The bench top is a little bit different. I've just sprayed over the board that I've been using, so that it's all one colour, just to give you a better background, really. So hopefully when that's dry, that'll work. My son was out here building a kit yesterday, bless him, on his own. Done my classic of pinging parts onto the floor for the carpet monster, so at least the carpet monster's fed anyway. So I will now try and find the colour that I want. That's one of them. Here I have all my... didn't use that one actually, I think. My Tamiya paints. See if I can bring you in a bit to so I can sort of see, so you can sort of see what I'm doing. Well, what I'm going to use for the seats is XF58, which is olive green. So we'll see how that goes. Take that off, I think. I don't mind at this point going over some bits because once I have, then I can always go back over it. So neaten it up. And I didn't want to do this with an airbrush because I think if you do this, do seating, cockpit seating and things like that with a brush, gives you a little bit more character. I think personally. That's quite a nice colour, quite like that. I do try not to get it onto other parts because obviously I don't want a load of clean up to do. Quite happy with that. Actually, I might on this bit, I might cover the lot and then paint the detail in after, I think. Bottom piece has to be painted yellow anyway, so it's all good. Put the clip back on it. Headrest is done in black, so it's not olive green. a little bit of a mould thing there. And there we go. We let those dry. And we'll come back in a bit for the next one. Right then, while they're drying, guys, what I thought I would do is attempt to paint the bottom, the floor of the cockpit. This time using a flat brush. One, because it's a large flat area, and it should cover better and I should be able to get a nice straight edge. Second part, as I said in the previous video, this is basically going to go on my son's either ceiling, if I do it wheels up, because I have no room in the shed for anything now. So I should really, I should think about maybe building the kit and maybe selling it. Sell it on eBay or something. Or even giving them away. Never been too sort of confident in my own ability and whatnot, so always doubt myself and whether things that I do are good enough. And I'm not fishing for compliments or anything, guys, so please don't. But yeah, that's not too bad, that's alright, I quite like that. And that's the same colour that I need for the headrests, so I can always do those next. While the paint is out, detailed brush on it for this. And again, we'll need to go over it anyway, so it doesn't have to be too neat, too tidy. Oh, I'm not in shot. Sorry, guys. Not too bad, not too bad. So if you can't see this bit, excuse me. That's looking a little bit better. This is what I like about acrylic paints. You can basically almost instantly just move on to the next colour. Nice. Where are you? There you go. Obviously, still a bit of work to do with them. Spotted a bit that I can paint now. On the cockpit top. Still gotta get used to this camera being over the top. Trying to be able to do things and keep in shot. There we go. There we go. out. Yellow. This is going to need a couple of coats. Most of your modelers will know, yellow isn't an easy colour to use, or isn't a nice colour even to use. So just let that dry. I don't think you really need to see me watching painting the second one up, so I'll see you in a bit. Right guys, what I've done needs a little bit of clean up. Nope, that way. There we go. Try and get in a decent shot, eh? Paint the wiring on there, There's a bit of wiring on there. Have to paint the backs of the instrument panels, but there are some horrendous ejector pin holes, so just filled those, and on this one as well. So once that's dried, I can get that filed down and get those painted. There's still a little bit more to do on the ejector seats by the looks of it. A little bit of detail painting still. I think I've gone out of shot again. A little bit better. It's always nice, I think, when you add that little bit of detail. It makes everything come alive, makes everything pop. That's okay. And there we go with that. Right then guys, I think I might go and get something to eat because I am starving. Just going over the bits that went over. Should have done a before and after shot, shouldn't I? Let's have a quick look over the seats, see where I've gone over. Very, very fine line there. Other than that, it doesn't look three bad. And the other one. Yeah, that needs a bit of attention. Just there. and there, and there. A little tiny bit there. There we go, that's better. And what I'd also do while I've got it is I'll just go over the seatbelt bit there so that the other colour when it goes on won't have to cover the green. There we go. And a little bit there. Coming together nicely. So we'll leave it there for now, guys. Like I said, I'm getting a bit hungry, so I'm going to go and grab something to eat. And come back when that's dry. Well, when all of that's dry. And we'll get some more done. And get these bits rubbed down, filed off, and get them painted, then we can get into black and the dark iron. That's what I was going to do. Maybe I'm not going to stop just yet. Nice. Won't see the underneath, but hey ho. There we go. That's a little bit of detail, I guess. Now I am stopping at the fourth attempt or so. There we go, guys. I'll see you back in a bit. Right then, guys, gonna paint the upper part of the straps in XF62 olive drab. It is raised just a fraction, so you do have to paint down the sides slowly. On that one. And again, the same thing, if you go over, it's easy enough just to go back in again with the other colour. Right up to the edge. Probably actually quite a bit easier. coming on not too bad. Actually, there's another bit. I'm going to do a darker shade. Sort of like a strap under the strap, if you know what I mean. Clearly visible. Use a little bit of the darker colour as well. Just give a little bit of low light or highlight, whichever way you want to look at it. Not going to be very visible or prominent, but it's there. Subtle, so to speak. Yeah, I like that. Coming together nicely. Now I need a cocktail stick. Semi-gloss black. camera's going a bit misty, guys, so I'll stop it just there for a minute. Right, back again. Just need to come back in with the yellow to do the sides of the seats. If I can get in there. That looks a bit better now. And that's basically the seats done. Well, actually it's not. Gonna have to come back with silver to do the buckles on the seat belts. Then we do the chrome silver. That's X8 lemon yellow I used there. Need to try and find the chrome silver. Actually, let's use titanium silver. That'll look nice. We need a nice mix up there. Lots of sludgy goodness in the bottom of that pot. Yeah, I forgot to mention, guys, as I said, just crossed the 3,000 hour viewing threshold, which allows me or enables me to be able to sell things on my channel and things like that, but or to charge people, get people to pay money for in a live chat. Well, I don't do live chats really anyway, so I'm not going to use that, so that doesn't really count. But I don't think that's the sort of thing you should do anyway. I don't know what you guys think about that, but I don't know if I would want to charge people just for sticking an emoji or whatever up or something like that. does sort of sit right, I suppose. Doesn't make sense to me. I can't imagine people wanting to do that anyway. Just dry brushing a bit of silver. Bring out a bit of detail on the side of the chairs. Hope you can see that. I must admit, I was thinking a little while ago about designing and maybe printing my own t-shirts. So if I do decide to do that, would anyone be interested? Leave a comment, let me know. And also, what should I put on it? Should it just be my logo? Or should I put, I don't know. I went on YouTube and all I got was this t-shirt. Something like that, maybe. There we go, the seat's done. The seat's painted. They still need to be, there's a couple of decals that need to go on them. I think what I'll do is I'll let all the paint dry properly first. And then just before we go, obviously this is now dry, has been dry, so all that lovely filler that I put in yesterday. We can sand that away. That needs to be filled some more. Still need a bit more filler in, I think, personally. So, having sanded this flat, needs a bit in there and a little bit in there and in there. So I don't think these two really too anything to bother about, really. So it's going to be right down at the bottom. You won't see that. I don't even think you'll see these, to be honest, because that there is a section that goes behind that. Some nice painting to do on that. Now on the instructions for the instrument panels on the sides of the cockpit, it shows that there's a lot of black panels, but actually on the GR1 all the panels were grey, so I will be leaving them, but I will be doing a different colour grey for some of the panels because some of them are different. This actually needs to be painted on because some of the paint isn't there where I used the clips. So I'll just paint that in. I did all that, so that's good. So that's good. Well, what I'll do, guys, is I'm going to pause you there for a sec. I'll go and get some water, then we'll get these decals put onto the seat sides, and then we'll end it there, ready for the next part of painting up the cockpit. And then the assembly of that. So what we used was this. Just spotted a little bit of over paint, if you like. So I'm just going to tidy that up. Just done this inside, the inside of here. That looks better. That's better. Yep, that's better. That is so much better. As they say, the devil's in the detail, I guess. So excuse me. Right, so guys, back in a mo. Right then guys, we have, according to the image on the instructions, we have decals number 37 and 38, which are here. Looks like some nice cockpit detail there, decals. So I think I've got some, maybe some scraping and filing to do. We'll see. Right, so 37 goes on the left side. So Microsoft. Microset. Two different brushes. And then we have the decals. And the tweezers. So we do 37 first, make sure I get the right ones. These go at the top. Yeah. And there. We need the good old cotton bud. gently manoeuvre that into place. Should have really have given this a gloss coat. Really. But like I said, it's only going into my son's room, so there's no excuse though, really. I should be doing it correctly. But I will do, I will give it a clear coat afterwards. Yeah. And to the other side. Blue microset on first. That's that. So that is the deliberate mistake. That's better. Stuck to my finger. Whichever way you look at it, whether it's planes, tanks or whatever, once those decals go on, it does add that certain special something. And there we go. So that, guys, is that for now. Maybe you can see that very well, but that's how it is. The seats are now done, with the exception of a gloss coat, which I will do. So when we come back in the next one, like I say, it'll be onto the cockpit, getting the parts painted, doing all the minute detail, unless we use the decals. I might give the decals a go, giving them, make an attempt. But we'll see. We shall see. We'll see how it goes. So, thank you very much for watching, guys. And I look forward to seeing you back in for the next one. Bye for now.